gotten the same message, so he was doing the exact same thing as I was.
It's like a telephone tree.
Exactly.
How's it going, everybody? Spring's here. A little bit of snow behind me, but not too much left. With spring comes running water, and with running water comes rainbow trout season. But right now, heading out to a few creeks, gonna see if we can get some trout. And Joe here today. It's strange times right now. We aren't really allowed to get too close to each other. But we took two separate vehicles up. We're gonna be fishing separate fishing holes, and most are here just to crack jokes across the creek and if we get into trouble, there's somebody to help bail us out instead of calling emergency services or something like that. But anyways, yeah, gonna hit this creek first. Then another two or three after this to check out. A little early in season, but great day to get out.
What?
All right, so,
ooh, that doesn't sound good.
Shit. All right, so I gotta tie my lure. I'm using yarn today with anisette oil on hooks and then beads on my line. I'm using also a three-way swivel. I have a split shot down below so that gets snagged and my lure doesn't. Essentially, this is gonna represent spawn to the fish in the murky water right now, and they'll go after where food source is around and appropriate for this time of year. So spawns, one of the things they'll be eating this time of year. So yeah, I'm gonna cut a little chunk. This is really exciting though. I haven't been out in over a month. Nice to get out. It's good to get be away from people. As I told myself, I was coming out here, if it's busy, being the spots are busy, I'm not gonna go see them. Just keep distance from people, right? Still is important, even though it's middle of nowhere. Anyways, okay. Starting to watch me fumble with some fishing line. I'm gonna need some line for my bottom balancer, and I've forgotten to bring an extra reel, so I'm gonna take some off the end here to set up that up.
Don't hurt your teeth!
Just floss it!
I've actually done that many times
in the woods. Yeah, a floss with it?
Yeah.
That's ingenuity right there. This is neat, even though we're social distancing, we can still yell chat at each other, me and Joe. I was saying it's neat that even though we can social distancing, we can still yell chat.
There you go.
I brought walkie talkies.
I brought this.
Oh. All right, so I now have a three-way swivel tied in here, and then I have a bead
on some line coming here, and this is gonna go to my hook. Or sorry, coho. Coho. Cohos.
Whatever, bro.
A coho are more like rainbow. Yeah, like rainbow trout in shape and size. Coho. Coho, yo. Okay. All right, so keep this bead in place. Pulling up, there's a little rubber bung put in there. Let's pull through. There we go, I got a little bit sticking out. I'm gonna cut that off. Split shots on there. And voila. So now, gonna get some yarn, cut off a little strip. And put that yarn on my hook. Now I'm going to soak this in this stuff, fish oil, aniseed oil.
Well, I don't think they're here. Not yet. I'm gonna check another spot.
It's beauty down here, eh?
It's beautiful, man. Oh.
It's so nice.
All right. Back in the vehicle, heading to the next spot now. I better catch up to Joe. Here we are, second spot.
Well, time to get geared up at the second spot now. I'll go wear hip waders this time and bring my pack because we wandered a little further down here. I want some coffee and just have all that stuff with me.
I ain't gonna throw my boots in the pack though because my hip waders do not have much insulation, which is kind of a bummer.
The old school sampling waders that I used to wear at work.
Oh yeah, slickers, eh?
Sometimes you're lucky to get the neoprene ones, but the girls got those.
$65 staying tired. Something like that. I think these don't leak. We'll find out. Styling.
Oh, their stuff's gone. Okay.
Slingy action here. Go. Ooh, sure. Thanks, Joe.
cool right there, right? It could be at least. What does it look like in the summer? Pretty shallow?
A little more shallow. Doesn't feel good also.
Yeah.
That's the trophy stuff, right?
Yeah, that's cool.
Time to move on.
My steaks need electronics on ya! Oh, my gloves.
That's good.
Thank you. Expect to see one of those Batman and Robin shots walking up the wall. The grappling hook's gonna grip it. Oh, I saw that. Oh. Karaoke readout. Oh, this is just so cool. Okay. Whoa. I have a theory about that. Theory that during the day when it's warmer it starts dripping and there's higher wildness because there's more runoff, and then things cool up in the night, the reservoir drops a little bit, and then there's a left with like an infatuating level or runoff from the ground though. That's yeah. Nice lace tights. This is just neat. I like. Yo, ooh, there's a hole there. Yep. Might be able to get up on the shore there and follow. I don't know, that looks pretty good too, eh? Sure. Scootin'. You see that Sudbury? Looks like we found a little bit of another bend here. Ben's all messed up. Yeah. There's some chutes over there, eh?
That sounds good.
Get the scalp and the paria. Paria. A paria.
Yeah, I think so.
Alright, well, we aren't getting many fish here. It doesn't seem like they're in this river yet. We're gonna get back to our vehicles and on to the next one. Just gotta cross this first. We got back to the vehicles now, is loading up all our gear. We're gonna head on to the next river. This next river, I've been told, is one of the first ones to run clear in the spring, so it'll be our most likely chance of getting any rainbow trout today. Either way, it's been a beauty day. All right, time to get a move on. motorcycle.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, it was a good end of outboard motor, but I fixed it quick enough.
Hey buddy.
You're big.
Well, took a few casts here. Beautiful spot. No fish. Gonna head on down the river a little bit, check out some other spots, see if they aren't too crowded. Lots of room here though, it's really nice. Really nice. Early though.
Look here. Time to try out another fishing hole. Ooh, that's muddy. Any luck?
Oh! Well, I caught some Z's. No, I haven't had any bites or anything. I went in the water a bit and my boots gathered some, so I'm just trying to dry out a little bit now.
Makes sense.
But, no, it's nice. I'm just enjoying laying in the sunset, in the sunlight.
It's nice, really nice. Yeah, I didn't get anything either.
No.
But I got some soup.
Man, I'm happy just to be out, honestly. Like,
yeah.
I think that the water, like, I've been told, like, it's still a bit too cold at night. I know people are pulling them out, but I don't think they're fully out yet.
Yeah, yeah. Or if you're close to the river mouths or close to the lake maybe or something like that.
Right.
Mind you, I'm not very expert at this either.
I have no idea what I'm doing. If we try, we can try again in a week or not even, you know what I mean?
Yes.
We might. Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
I want one.
I'm into it. Oh, I can feel the warmth of the sun though. It's very nice.
That is nice. Spring.
Ring.
Well, no fish. But I got my little pocket rocket stove and some
some soup to make. I want to make some coffee too. Need a little bit of energy. Ooh, a buffalo head.
Oh yeah, we're flying. I love those guys.
Cool little penguins.
Little mini loons. Yeah, exactly.
I wish I had my camera in my hands. Maybe you folks saw it. I don't know. Okay.
Let me know in the comments if you saw it. Yeah, I ate a sandwich in the car on the way here, so I'm all right. I'm just gonna relax. I might even have a drink, have a snack. But...
Right on. Right on.
But I'm nice and comfortable here, man. Like, I could spend an hour here. Oh, I brought my hammock. I brought my hammock.
Brought my hammock. There we go. Bam, son.
I'm jealous now.
Things are happening now, boy.
I'm stuck here on the ground.
Ah, like a peasant. Dirt merchant.
Got some chips, some all dressed chips.
Chips?
I don't think they have all dressed chips in the States.
No, they don't. It's a Canadian thing.
It's a Canadian thing, like the ketchup chips. Although I'm not fond of the ketchup chips myself.
Near
my, once in a while at a party, I'll have a handful.
You know, it's splurge. You know, yeah, yeah. A little.
Yeah.
There's a province-wide fire ban right now in Ontario. So, no more fires for a bit. Good twig stoves. I got this nifty little pocket rocket here, which is quite nice. So I got myself another kimchi bowl. Mr. Noodle edition. Fuji apple. French press, some homemade cookies that Brittany made. Oh, I got creamer and stuff too. Coffee, sugar, creamer. All right, let me get some water. Is ready to go. Wait 5 minutes. Got my kimchi bowl. Good to go.
Yeah, just waiting time. Ah, christening is upon us.
Slick.
I like it. You can drink right out of it, but I don't want to put dairy in it or anything and get all grimy. I like my palm oil.
Socrates?
Sophocles.
Socrates, what's up?
Socrates, go. Good to go? Oh, good to go.
One of them. Mmm. Pretty good. Doesn't taste like it's real cream in it. Pretty good. The hammock's nice and everything, but yeah, feel just a cop a squat.
It's crazy, the last outdoors activity I did was cross-country skiing.
I saw that. The last overnight I did before my last one? Probably with Jim.
Oh yeah. I was right around then.
Middle of the winter.
That's cool you guys get to hang out.
Yeah, he's a good guy. He's huge, man.
He's a monster.
I said in my live stream last night when I was on that podcast, I was like, what's your bucket list trip? I was like, I wanna go like the Yukon, do like a Yukon River trip, but like I'm kinda intimidated by grizzlies because I've never really been around them, but like if I kill someone like Jim Bear, he could probably just fight it. Like it'd be okay. Or, yeah, like, get out of here, grizzly. In your lifetime, your mother and whoever made food for you, and then yourself, is it a normal thing to peel carrots?
Yeah.
Okay. Why though?
Just get the dirt off easier than washing it.
Right, but there's so much taste and nutrients in this kind. For me too. Everyone, my whole life, my mom cut off, Will cut off, yeah. I cut off. And I'm like, I read this book. It's called Eat Dirt. It's by a doctor. I just stopped. I just started like just washing them a bit.
I love the taste. Way more. Super carroty.
I didn't see that. Like celery. The celery leaves. You can use them in the soup or more, give more flavor than the stock does.
Yeah, my mom always used to save them for soups and stuff.
Andy.
So I have that, I have that GoPro 8 or 7 and I broke the lens on it pretty quickly. I popped the lens off the other night and I ordered a new one. I didn't realize you could just order a brand new one.
That's awesome.
It's awesome, it's right. But look at this, Osmo Action Cam just freaking unscrews. And then you need a wider angle.
Yeah.
That's the jam.
Yeah.
I know. I like these. Might have to save a life for Boosh.
Where's the other one?
Yeah, that was Boston Terrier or
exactly.
Is it the Boston?
That was low for that.
Yeah.
Alright. You got the old fold the cup going. Oh, that's not a fold the cup. Fold the cups are Swedish. What is this one? Do you know what these are called, Boosh?
Hold a cup.
Hold a cup.
I don't know.
Who's approved? So cool. Anyway, we got that going. Got my carrots and celery.
Come on, everyone. Teenage Mutant Ninja.
Well, no fish. Still had some good lunch. Beautiful day, got a little bit of a tan. Anyways, we're gonna head home. Got my gear packed up. Joe's just throwing his pack on right now. We're not really doing our usual side-by-side talks right now because we want to space out a little bit. But anyways, it was a good day. There may be more of these. It was a lot of fun, so I want to come out again and get a little better at this. Anyways, yeah, so thanks for watching. I'll see you on the flip side. Everybody stay safe.